Hello, 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 and thank you for tuning on to another episode of our Scripture Breakdown Ministry. My name is David Abraham, and our scripture for today comes from Psalm 40, verse 4, and it says, "Blessed is that man who makes the Lord his trust, and does not respect the proud, nor such as turn aside to lies." I repeat, blessed is that man who makes the Lord his trust, and does not respect the proud, nor such as turn aside to lies. Now, I want to divide the scripture into three parts. The first part says, blessed is the man who makes the Lord his trust. Now, the key words here are blessed, which is a reward. Then the condition for receiving this reward is trust. And who do we trust? We trust in the Lord. We trust in Jehovah Nissi. We trust in the Creator of the heavens and earth. We trust in the I Am that I Am. We trust in the King of Kings. We trust in the Ruler of the universe. We trust in the One through God. So he said, blessed is that man who makes the Lord his trust. So who is this man that makes the Lord his trust? The man that makes the Lord his trust is the blessed man. So trusting in the Lord is an entirely different ball game entirely. Trusting the Lord involves putting your total reliance on your total self on the Lord. It's like leaning on a wall and expect that the wall would not fall. The wall would not fall backwards because of your weight. That is the way we trust in the Lord. You trust in the Lord in every area of your life. Trust in the Lord with your life, with the fact that you breathe every day. Trust in the Lord in your finances, the fact that you are sure and you know that God will provide for you. Trust in the Lord in when you go out and when you come in, you know that you are protected. You know God, the wings of God, the wings of the angels of God are over you. You know that he will lift you up in their hands so that you do not trample your feet on the stones. So trusting the Lord involves total reliance and total leaning on the person of God. So here, after experiencing this trust and after going through this situation of continuous trust in your everyday life, God endorses it and he sees you as justified because you trust in him. And after justification, he blesses you. So he's blessed is the man who makes the Lord his trust. Blessed is the man who makes the Lord his trust. Blessed is that man who makes the Lord his trust. And the second is that does not respect the proud. So who is the proud? The Bible refers to a proud man as a wicked man. The wicked man is a proud man. The man who is haughty. The man who has no regards for his fellow man, the man who believes that he is a superior human being in the scheme of things, a man who believes that he made whatever position he got to, is self-made, and therefore he does not really need anything from God. Now, the proud man here is a wicked man, and does not respect the proud. So we trust the Lord and we not respect the wicked, not respect the position that they hold or whatever they have or whatever they want to show off. We do not respect it because we put our total reliance and our total trust in God. And last we said, no such as turn aside to lies. Now, what are lies here in this context? Turning aside to lies is turning aside away from the truth. The truth is God. The truth is the trust in the Lord. The truth is faith. The truth is justification of God. The truth is the continuous fellowshipping with God and believing that all he says and does will continually follow after it to bring to life, to bring to birth the purpose for which we came to the earth. But turning to lies is turning to the ways of the ungodly, turning into the ways of the sinners, following after the the attitudes and the behavioral patterns of the sinners and turning away from the trust which we have in God. So turning and following after the ungodly is turning aside to lies. Now I want to pray that God is able to expound our minds on this word, that God is able to give us more revelational knowledge, that we would be able to walk with it and run with that. Ultimately, God is able to give us more and more and more grace to continually trust in Him and go after Him in everything that we do, that we will be able to turn away from lies, and we would be able not to envy or jealous any wicked act in our lives or outside our environments. All these are asked through Jesus Christ our Lord. I thank you so much for listening, and God bless, God bless, God bless in Jesus' name. Amen, amen.